again to all of you guys, gals, and non-binary pals. It is your host, Athena Sarmiento, and welcome back to another show of Whitney High Live. I hope you guys have all had a great Wednesday so far, and to kickstart off our show, we have an announcements video talking about ASB elections.
I like ASB because of our great community and work dynamic.
I love ASB because I'm actually able to be a part of shaping the high school experience for my classmates.
I love ASB because it's a great experience. I learned how to grow and learned how to be a good leader. I also love the people I work with and the great environment I'm surrounded by.
In a normal school year, ASB works a lot. We're constantly getting ready for different events. We have our amazing ASB retreat at the beginning of the year, and we also do a lot of work to support our sports and the arts programs.
In an online setting, ASB is still really busy doing lots of things, whether it's rethinking events or creating brand new ones. We've got a lot to do, but most importantly, ASB's main goal is to make Whitney a more inclusive and connected place.
Monday, March 8th marks the first day of our Foreign Language Spirit Week. So, on Monday, you will be wearing flag colors or logo from another country. On Tuesday, you will be wearing a scarf and or traditional garment from another country. On Wednesday, you will be wearing sports team gear from another country. On Thursday, you can bring food from another culture into your class. And on Friday, the last day, you will be sharing a foreign language idiom on your social media. So, with Black History Month coming to a close recently, here's a recap video from Young Black Scholars.
Hey Whitney, so for the first week of Black History Month, our theme was Black influence in music, and in our meeting we dissected the African origins of certain musical genres and highlighted Black pioneers in music. And in our second week, we collaborated with Girl Up and Threaded and had an amazing intersectional feminism seminar where we made posters for the virtual march. And we had teacher speakers come and talk about their personal experiences with feminism.
And for our third week of Black History Month, we had a meeting on the beauty of all things Black, where we discussed the aspects of brown cultures that might not be accepted by Western standards of beauty. And this included a discussion on how we, as Whitney High School and a Whitney community and family, can take a stand against racism, featureism, colorism that we might see on campus and in the world today. And for our last week of Black History Month, we kicked off our Talk About It series, which will be a series of talks with guest speakers who are experts on a specific topic that has to do with history, modern day, or the future. And this will include controversial topics and political discussions, all that good stuff. And so our guest speaker was Professor Roger A. Fairfax Jr., and he spoke on the transformation of the criminal legal system and justice reform. And so this included the history of the criminal legal system and where we hope that it's going.
Hey guys, so even though Black History Month has ended, we need to remember that Black history and Black culture plays a huge role in our lives every day, so we need to make sure to acknowledge it and celebrate it every day of the year.
We'd like to thank everyone for coming out to our Black History Month meetings. We hope to see you all in our regular meetings.
Starting next month, we're going to be starting a program to help support small businesses during the pandemic. So please make sure to check out our platforms to suggest small business to help support and just to keep up with any other updates.
Thank you so much, YBS. Now here's Vianney interviewing Jaws.
Hey guys, we are Jaws, a high school drag and looney team based in SoCal. I'm Chloe Kennett and I'm the head coach.
Hi everyone, I'm Monica Lee and I'm the logistics captain. Hi, I'm Clara Kim, and I'm the finance captain.
And I'm Giselle Galandia, and I'm the bonding and fitness captain. We've decided to recruit our upcoming spring season, which starts on Saturday, March 6th.
All high schoolers are able to join. We've had students from all over the ABC Unified District, as well as other students from Kennedy, Troy, Los Alamitos, and Cypress. So if you are in the SoCal area, we highly recommend that you join the team.
Our spring season will mostly be online, meaning that we will have virtual fitness practices where we work out together and have bonding and activities on a Zoom call in order to stay safe and connected during this pandemic.
In the next few weeks, up until the start of our spring season, we will be having Instagram takeovers on our JAWS Instagram account at JAWSDDT with a few of our team members, Instagram lives with us, your captains, where you can ask us questions, and a lot more exciting things for us to hype up this time of recruitment.
We'll also be having an informational meeting on Friday, March 5th, which is the day right before spring season starts, from 7 to 8 p.m. We'll be giving more information regarding the upcoming season and just JAWS in general, and probably answer any more questions that you guys might have, so go mark your calendars.
If you have any questions or concerns, feel free to contact us individually or reach our Instagram account at JAWSDDT, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can.
Continue to stay safe, please wear your masks, and be mindful to those around you.
And we hope to see you as one of our members in the upcoming season.
Join JAWS!
Join JAWS!
Join JAWS!
And please don't forget to join JAWS. Bye!
Monday, March 1st marks the first day of Women's History Month, and we have a video just for that. Here's one from Eli.
Hey guys, it's Eli, and I'm here to remind you that March is Women's History Month. I've always wondered why and how things get their own month, and I'm sure I'm not the only one. So today I'll be giving a quick summary on how Women's History Month came to be. Its roots date back all the way to 1917 on March 8th, which we now know as International Women's Day. During World War I, members of the women's movement in Russia organized a march to peacefully protest the war. After news of it spread throughout Europe, it became a significant date to the women's movement, to the point where rallies took place all over Europe the very next year. Although it was remembered for many years after the first march, it wasn't until 1977 that March 8 was formally recognized by the United Nations as International Women's Day. The year after that, 1978, Sonoma County in California decided to celebrate for one whole week instead of just one day. The idea of celebrating Women's History Week slowly spread throughout the country, and by 1980, Jimmy Carter issued a presidential proclamation that the first week of March would be Women's History Week. The increasing recognition of the holiday in communities around America resulted in 14 states declaring that March would be Women's History Month by 1986. The very next year, 1987, Congress ended up declaring that Women's History Month would be nationally recognized. Ever since then, the National Women's History Alliance declared an annual theme for the year. And for 2021, the theme is Valiant Women of the Vote, Refusing to be Silenced, which celebrates the women that fought for women's suffrage in the United States.
Thank you so much, Eli. And last but certainly not the least, we have a video from Shanti Clem. Check it out.
Want to support a great cause?
Do you miss dancing with your friends?
Or are you just bored out of your mind during quarantine?
Shanti Club presents our very own virtual culture show.
To anyone who is not familiar with this event, Shanti Club hosts its culture show, which is a themed production with dance and music performances by students of all grade levels at Whitney. This takes place at the end of every school year and showcases Indian culture from various regions of the subcontinent.
Our usual acts include class dances,
Bhangra, hip-hop, Bollywood, South Indian, classical, as well as musical collaborations with other clubs. Don't feel intimidated if you don't know how to dance, as no prior experience in dancing is necessary. All of our choreography is made with beginners in mind and is easier to learn. As always, you do not need to be Indian to participate in the show. Everyone is welcome.
If you are an experienced dancer and want to participate in more complex choreography, there are more difficult dances such as classical, bhangra, and hip-hop for you to sign up for as well. However, if you would like to showcase your individual talent in dance, singing, or instrumentals, there is also an option for you to audition for a solo piece.
Although this year we have been affected by the pandemic and can no longer have in-person practices, we still wanted to create an opportunity to celebrate Indian culture together. In order to comply with social distancing guidelines, here are the following measures of safety we will be implementing this year.
First and foremost, all practices will be conducted over Zoom. We will keep costumes simplistic, and if you don't have the necessary costumes or clothes, we will bring you the new and unused ones. Unlike previous years, we will not allow people to borrow others' clothes for the show. The only time we'll be meeting in person is during the final filming of the show.
In terms of filming, we will only film a maximum of 4 people per video. In each dance, you will have the freedom to choose which group of people you are comfortable dancing with. These can be your friend circles or people you feel safe with. Masks must be worn at all times during filming, and we will ensure that social distancing guidelines are being followed at all times. We are adjusting the acts in the show to follow the guidelines by removing all partner dances and instead making available more spots for solo acts.
Moving on to the theme of this year's culture show, we will be putting a modern spin on Indian mythological characters. The name of this year's culture show is, drumroll please, Missing. The show revolves around our two main characters, Sure Love and Dr. Kush. And the show basically follows them as they solve a serial kidnapping case.
They must find the three princesses, Princess Sita, Princess Rukmini, and Gopi Radha. To solve these cases, they must find clues leading them to each princess, who gives them a new lead to find the next princess. Watch and participate in the show to find out what happens.
So, if you're at all interested in participating in Virtual Culture Show this year, take out your phone and scan this QR code on the screen to access the interest form.
Another way to access this form is through the link down below. Hope to see all of you dancing.
That is all that we have for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember, always stay happy, always stay healthy, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye-bye.